Good morning, children. Now let us begin the topic, that is arithmetic mean. Means after completion of 14.3 exercise, before going for 14.4 exercise, let us have the definition of arithmetic mean, that is also known as mean, median and mode. All the three definitions we will see along with its formula, and then we will go to the exercise 14.4. Okay, now before that, see. Arithmetic mean means the average of given set of numbers is called the arithmetic mean or mean of the given numbers. Okay, now formula is mean equals to sum of observations upon number of observations. Like you all might be giving one example, I am going to give. You all are writing the exams and how many subjects you have? Basically main subjects you are giving as 7 subjects, like English, Hindi, Maths, Science, Social Science, Sanskrit and then Moral Science. 7 subjects you got. So out of that 7 subjects, whatever marks you got for each subject, that you have to add it, and upon number of subjects, that is 7, when you do, you are getting what? Average. Is it not? Like sum of all the subjects, that is English plus Hindi plus Maths plus Science plus Social Science, then plus Sanskrit, and upon 7, because how many subjects are there? 7 subjects. So upon 7 will give what? Mean. This is called mean. Okay, so mean is sum of all the observations upon number of observations. So here how many subjects are there? 7 subjects. So sum of all the subject marks upon total number of subjects. So there are 7 subjects, so divide by 7, so you will get the mean. Clear, children? Understood? With this example, I think the topic mean is clear. Now let us take likewise only if that x1, x2, x3, ... xn are the observation. Means these are the marks, suppose. For example, x1, x2, x3, ... xn are the observations. Then mean will be what? Up to n terms are there. Okay, so n terms means number of observation will be n only, and the sum of observations will be x1 plus x2 first number plus second number plus third number plus ... till xn. Okay, that is called sum of observations upon total number of observation, which is in formula wise in summation sign. This is called summation sign. So in summation form, how will you write? That is summation of I equals to 1. Means here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ... till which number? N. So likewise, I equals to 1 to N means, and xi means here I will change every time. That is I equals to 1, x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4. Likewise, it will come up to xn. Okay. So in short form of this same thing, you will write as summation of I equals to 1 to n xi upon n, that is the number of observations. Clear? Mean is clear to everyone? Now median. After arranging, suppose any numbers I have written like 3, 4, then 1, then 5, then 2, then 7. So if you see these numbers, can you say is this is arranged one? No. So numbers are written haphazardly, means not in an order. So if I write the same numbers either in ascending or in descending order, then it is called what? Arrangement of data. Clear? So that is what here it is given. After arranging the data in ascending or descending order of magnitude. Magnitude means its value. Higher number will come in descending order, higher number will come to the first, then next less, then less, then less, likewise it will go on. And if it is in ascending order, first smaller number, then next, 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 it keeps on increasing. Right? So that is called its magnitude. The value of the middle observations, suppose this I am writing as 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5 and then 7. So middle order here you can see one more number if I am writing here like 8. So here one more 8. So here 3 order gone, 3 here gone. So which is the middle term? 4. So that is the value of the middle observation is the median of data. So we can say 4 is the median of data. Okay, clear, understood. So but in median of ungrouped data, when this is called your ungrouped data, because they are not formed in groups, this type of data is ungrouped one. Okay, grouped means you know class interval, that is 0 to 5, then 5 to 10, then 10 to 15. Likewise, when we are writing, this is called what? Grouped data. So now we will see the median of ungrouped data. Okay, so here we were saying that this is the middle term, but I never said this is the median. Okay, this is the middle term. So when you are having ungrouped data, in that case you have to first see whether n, that is the number of observation, is even or odd. First you have to check. So here suppose this is the numbers I have written. Okay, so now count the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 means what? Even or odd? That is odd. So if n is odd, then the median will be what? Value of n plus 1 upon 2th observation. N plus 1 means what is that n here? N equals to what? 7, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. N is 7. 7 plus 1 is how much? 8. That is equals to 8 upon 2. So what is that? Equals to 4. That means 4th term will be your observation, that is the median. So 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the median. Clear, understood? That way you will find in case of ungrouped data. So now, if n is even, suppose I have written a number called 1, 2, 4, 6, 8 and then 9. Likewise I wrote. Then you can see what is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many terms are, numbers are there? 6 numbers are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 means what? Is this even? If n is even, then median will be what? Mean of n upon 2th term and n upon 2 plus 1th term. Mean means what? Again divide by 2. Average. Okay. So this I can write in another way, that is median equals to n upon 2th term plus n upon 2 plus 1th term upon 2. So here you will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 means n equals to what? N equals to 6. Okay. So now here median will be what? Median equals to first one is 6 upon 2th term plus 6 upon 2 plus 1th term, okay, upon 2. So now here 6 upon 2 means what? 3. Here also 3 means here it is 3rd term plus 4th term, because 3 plus 1 will be what? 4. 4th term upon 2. So here 4th term and 3rd term, which one it is? 1, 2, 3. This is 3rd and this is 4th. So sum of these two, that means what? 3 plus 4 plus, what is that term? 4 plus, what is that 4th term? 6 upon 2. So addition is 10 upon 2, which will give what? 5. So the median will be 5 here in this case. Clear? Understood? So now, mode of ungrouped data. Mode of ungrouped data means, mode is very very easy one, because after arranging the data either in ascending order or in descending order, you have to see the number of times the particular number observed. Okay, the maximum number of occurrence of that number is called the mode. So now here you can see 14. So see how many times 14 came in this ungrouped data. That is 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So 14 how many times came? 4 times. Then you can see 25, only 1 time. Then 28, 1 time. 28 also 1 time. Then 18, how many times? See, 1, 2, 3.
So 18 how many times came? 3. And then what else? 17 how many times? 1 time. And 22 also 1 time. 23 also 1 time. So see that which number is occurred maximum. You can see here 4. 4 means which number it is? 14. So which number occurred most of the time here in this particular ungrouped data? That is 14. So our mode will be equals to 14. Okay, clear? Then most number of times or the most frequently occurring number in ungrouped data is called the mode. Clear, children? Understood? Now let us deal with the exercise 14.4 first question. Okay? For exercise 14.4 first question goes like this. The following numbers of goals were scored by a team in a series of 10 matches. Okay, so the scores or the goals were given as 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 3, 4, 3. Okay, find the mean, median and mode of these scores. It is given in the book, that question, NCERT first question. So now the goals are given as 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 3, 3, 4, 3. Likewise, the goals were given. Now the total number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total number of observations are 10. Now mean formula we know, that is sum of observations upon number of observations. So here sum of observations upon number of observations. Now this sum of observation means whatever numbers are given that we have to add. Okay, so that is 2 + 3 + 4 + 5 + 0 + 1 + 3 + 3 + 4 + 3 means whatever numbers are given, just add it, sum of all the numbers. Okay, upon the number of observations. How many number of observations are there? 10. So sum of all the numbers upon 10, that is equals to, when you add this numerator you will get what? 28. So 28 upon 10, you know that 10 is there in the denominator, means we can write as 2.8. okay, so how many goals? That is mean is 2.8 goals. Therefore you can write mean equals to 2.8 goals. Okay, clear children? Understood this one? Now because we know that mean is very very easy, because mean means sum of all the numbers upon number of observations. Okay, now after that what we have to do? First we have to arrange the data either in ascending or in descending order. So here we are taking the data in ascending order. So ascending order means whatever data is there that I can write like first 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 3, then 3, then 3. Compare with the given data. Okay, in the question, 0 is there first because ascending order. So 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, 3, 3, 3. You can see how many times it is. Then 4, 4, 5. Okay, so now you know that total number of observation equals to what? 10. We have seen in that first part also. That is 10 observations. That means 10 is what? Even or odd? Here n is what? This total number of observation equals to 10 means what? N equals to 10. So n equals to 10 means what? Is it even or odd? Even. So if it is even, the formula we have seen, either n or the number of observation is even, then formula is n upon 2 2th term plus n upon 2 plus 1th term upon 2. Okay, so here what is n? N is 10. So 10 upon 2th term plus n upon 2, that means 10 upon 2 plus 1th term upon 2. Now 10 upon 2 means 5. So 5th term plus 10 upon 2 means 5. 5 plus 1 will be what? 6. So 6th term upon 2. So now 5th term and 6th term, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 5th term
and this is sixth term. So sum of fifth and sixth term. So here what is that fifth term? That is 3, and here sixth term is what? 3. So 3 plus 3 upon 2. Okay, clear, understood? That is equals to 3 plus 3 means 6 upon 2 will give 3. Therefore, median equals to what? 3. Clear, understood? Now, for mode. Mode means what? We know that most frequently occurring number will be the mode. So now for that, make a frequency distribution table. That is, likewise, on the top right goes and below column row, write down frequency. Then write the numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here it is given. So here all, what all numbers are there, that only you write. Okay, not all the numbers. Only one, how many times it is occurred, that will be the frequency. Okay, so only the numbers, repetition ones, we will not write 10 times or 5 times repeated ones. Only one time only we will write that number. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so in these particular numbers, question, how many times 0 came? You can see, only one time, so one frequency. How many times 1 came? That is also one time. How many times 2 came? 1, only one time. Then 3, how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 times 3. And then 4, how many times? 1, and then 2. So 2 times 4. And 5 how many times? Only one time. So what? Now see the frequency, which one is the most occurring number? You can see this one, that is 4 times. So we can say that 3 occurs most frequently, that is 4 times. How many times 3 came? 4 times. Therefore, mode is 3. Because maximum times the number is occurring. Okay, is called the mode. So here 3 is represented how many times? Or is written 4 times. So 3 is the mode. Okay, first one is clear. Now see the second question. In a mathematics test given to 15 students, the following marks out of 100 are recorded. 41, 39, 48, 52, 46, 62, 54, 40, 96, 52, 98, 40, 42, 52 and 60. These are the marks given in the question paper. That means your exercise 14.4 second question marks are written for mathematics test. Okay. And then you have to find what? Mean, median and mode of this data. So now you can see total number of students are how many? In the question you can see. That is 15 students are there. Now their mathematics marks are given as 41, 39, 48, 52, 46, 62, 54, 40, 96, 52, 98, 40, 42, 52 and 60. These are the marks given. That means 15 students, their mathematics marks. Now mean will be what? Sum of observations upon number of observations. We know now sum of these all marks upon total number of students. Okay. So these marks, mathematics marks of 15 students. Sum of mathematics marks of 15 students upon 15. Okay. Upon 15. Now when you add these all, that is 41 plus 39 plus 48 plus 52 plus 46 plus 62 plus 54 plus 40 plus 96 plus 52 plus 98 plus 40 plus 42 plus 52 plus 60. All these numbers are added up upon 15. So when you add, you will get 822. On adding these numbers, you will get 822 upon 15. So when you divide this, you will get 54.8. So our mean will be what? Therefore, mean equals to 54.8. Okay, this is mean answer. Now what we have to find? Median. So for median, again we have to arrange the data in ascending order and descending order. So now we will arrange this in ascending order. Most of the time, the data is arranged in ascending order only. Now arranging the data in ascending order, what we will get? That is 39 40, 40, 41, 42, 46, 48, 52, 52, 52, 54, 60, 62, 96, 98. Likewise, erased ascending order. You all know how to erase the data, given data in ascending order. After arranging, you check now whether the number of students are even or odd. N is even or odd. So now see, number of observations, that is 15. How many students are there? 15. So 15 is even or odd? Odd number. Okay. So which is odd? So if odd number means formula of median will be what? That is n plus 1 upon 2th term. N plus 1 upon 2th term. That is equals to what? What is n? That is 15. So 15 plus 1 upon 2th term. So 15 plus 1 will be what? 16. 16 upon 2th term will be what? On cancelling you will get 8th term. Now 8th term count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now which one you got? This number is the 8th term. So 8th term, that is 52, is the answer for median. Therefore median equals to what? 52. Answer got it for median. Now for mode, what mode? You have to first make the frequency table, then make first row as marks, second row as frequency. Now write each marks. Okay, that is 39, 40, 41, 42, 46, 48, 52, 54, 60, 62, 96 and 98. Now see how many times 39 occurred. You can see here 39, one time only. 39 one time, so 1. 40 how many times? 1, 2, so 2 times 40. 41, 1, only one time. Then 42 also, you see, 42, only one time, so 1. 46, 1, only one time. Then 48, 1, only one time. Then 52, 1, 2, 3 times. So 3 times 52 came. Then 54, 1, only one time. Then 60, only one time. Then 62, 1, only one time. 96, only one time. Then 98 also, one time. Okay, so you got the frequency table likewise. After that, you see which number is occurred maximum times. So here maximum times means what? 3. 3 is 3 times. Which one occurred? 52. So 52 number or marks is scored by how many students? 3 students. 52 is the marks, mathematics marks, scored by how many students? 3 students. So the mode will be 52. Therefore you can write here 52 is the most occurring, frequently occurring number. That is how many times it occurred? 3 times. Therefore mode will be 52. Means 3 students, maximum students got which number? That is 52. So 52 will be the mode for this particular question. Okay. Clear children? Understood? Okay. Thank you.